kept him in great shape.
He said, why do I need the cards? I don't want. Well, look under there. See if there's something that you want. Take it.
What's going on, guys? Welcome to Breaking with Breeze. And as you can see, we're here at the warehouse. And my friend Ben Brown here dug up some hidden treasures here, man. A lot of very cool cards. We're going to go through them a little bit, talk a little bit about them, and kind of see what we're working with here. This stuff is just kind of hidden. You dug it up, and they got all sorts of stuff. All sorts of stuff. It's all sealed and stuff like that. So we're going to kind of get our hands on it here.
So this is Wrestling All-Stars Series 1 and 2. How am I looking for?
They're actually still in like pretty good condition.
You want to know where they came from? They belong to somebody who is in this set.
Okay.
From their house. They were Pat Patterson's.
Really?
Yeah.
He kept them in great shape.
He said, why do I need the cards? I don't want. Well, look under there. See if there's something that you want. Take it.
Oh, I love that.
That's a solid Pat Patterson.
That's a good bat. That's a good bat.
You got that one down.
You can barely even tell it's him. Like, doesn't look like
rookie million dollar man. JYD.
I love the discussion of like what is a rookie for people, right? Like I think, you know, with the Andre, there's like, it's something out of a Japanese a Gong magazine. I have like a collection of like 200 Gong magazines from that time, and that card is not in there.
Really?
And I'm like, because they randomly put cards in there. It wasn't even like every single edition of this is the same card. Dory still looks the same.
He's born 30, man. Yes. Born 30. Born 60. They just don't change. Whoa.
Oh, Terry.
I mean, that's a young Terry. So, I know, like, definitely the first set, the one I probably see most out there is the Hogan, because this is considered like one of the first Hogans. And it's hard to find like a good condition one. But if you do, they're big. Andre, same. I mean, really, honestly, like, this is just kind of because it was just wrestling all-stars. It was like anybody who's in wrestling, they're probably in here, or the bigger names anyway. Because there wasn't like they didn't really divvy it up by like promotion or anything. It was just kind of like, here's Dusty, here's Andre, here's Hogan.
And were they not distributed via like a wrestling magazine? Like you had to order them from a wrestling magazine?
So honestly, I don't know how you would have gotten these back in the day. So like Pat, like did Pat just get them because he was in them?
Probably.
And whoever made them was like, here, have some.
Yeah.
Like that's, I don't know, you just don't, you can't like, you can't go on eBay and just buy a box of them and unbox them.
No. I've never, I don't think they came in a box. I think they came in like a loose pack.
Yeah.
Like, you know.
You had to have collected them. Like there's not a, it's not really, it's a set, but it's not, you can't buy a full set, I don't think. Or at least not now you can. So.
No, you, I mean, one, like the box, even Young if it was Backlund. Like a mailer, would have showed up by now.
Yeah.
There he is, the All-American boy, Bob Backlund.
Young guy. Like these are, these are kind of, I don't know, I'd have to look a little bit deeper in certain things, but these are like grail cards. Like people are very much after these ones. And I know a lot of them have like half sets, or they're missing certain ones, but like, I've never actually seen him in person yet. That's funny. Even that like Moolah Young. It was just a different time. Different time.
You see a lot of stuff like, I don't know if you see it on Twitter from time to time, like athletes from like or actors from the 70s and 80s. And like, there were 23 here and they look 52.
Yep.
And there he is.
Oh, Young Pat. Realistically, like when you talk to Pat, he didn't look that far off
from
this.
No, he didn't, no.
That's crazy.
This is another one of the more valuable ones from the set, Rick.
Yep, Flair's a big one.
And Putski.
That's because it was kind of crazy, because again, like, this was still territory time, so like, nobody worked under one umbrella. They were all over the place, so that's why it's just Wrestling All-Stars. That's a hell of a picture right there. That's a good, like, hey, this is what wrestling's all about
So Dick Byer only just passed like a couple of years ago, and he was the last guy he was the last wrestler who had wrestled Gorgeous George living.
Wow.
You know, up until, you know, just like I said, he just passed, like maybe 4 or 5 years ago.
Tully, young Tully?
Again, doesn't look a lot different.
430, grown man.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm 16 compared to Tully. Great condition. Very good, yeah. I don't know how they, I'd be curious how they judge like the centering on them.
That's a big element too, right? It's like, they'd be like, oh, this Hogan's perfect, except the centering is bad.
Yeah, and so that's like, I'm curious, because they do have a border on them. So like this Andre's a little,
So is it?
It's hard to tell. It's a little bit, so this is where it's hard too, is the cut of it. So like, he's a little bit close to the bottom. He has a little bit room up top, but they all might be like that. You'd have to kind of, like, there's no definitive border really. There's just kind of, you can look at the sides.
Yeah.
And the sides you can kind of gauge, but the top and the bottom, it could kind of go either way, especially on this first set. Like, it's so weird. They almost look like hand drawn. Like the, bottom little bump there is a little different on each card. It's not like a definitive thing. So I'm very curious how they would do the centering on this. But like, that Hogan is pretty good. And so is that Andre. Like, so that's, and again, that's where kind of grading comes in of like, you know, some person might see it one way, some person might see it another way. It just depends on the day and the person and whatever. But I mean, I'm very curious. Like overall, I mean, they've got a little bit of wear, which is to be expected. They're, you know, from, what, 1983. But overall, not bad for what you'd expect. But it's, again, it's hard to, like, you can search eBay and kind of look for them, and there's not a lot.
There's not a lot of that are graded super high either.
No, the ones that are graded are usually low.
Yeah.
Like, there's definitely, I haven't seen any, like, 10s or 9s, I don't think. If I did, it's probably listed somewhere for thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars.
I feel like there was a Ric Flair 9 that was somebody was trying to sell for like $80,000.
Yep.
Good lord.
I think I have seen maybe some signed ones that are graded.
Yeah.
And those ones are usually pretty big, but you'll see like some 5s and some 6s and stuff like that. That's a cool card. I wonder how old do you think he is? Right now?
I mean,
32.
Probably like 24.
I think he's early 20s.
Right, right.
That's what a grown man.
Early.
What
man.
A grown man.
There he is.
Wow.
The best. Jimmy Hart.
Young Jimmy looks.
Hold on.
He's still wearing that jacket too.
same mustache. Man, that is cool. So I've only seen some from the first set.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen the Rick set, and I don't know if I've seen all these ones.
Yeah, and again, this is 2/3 of the whole one. There's an entire set that I do not have. Bob Sutan, the ugliest man in wrestling.
He's 20 here. The grappler.
Did you guys deal with him, Lynn Denton? Cool.
No.
I think he was involved in developmental for a period of time, maybe like 3 or 4 years before you guys.
Really?
Yeah.
What developmental would it be?
I think it was not in Deep South.
Deep South, maybe?
Rouge. That one actually had a little bit of wear on it.
A little bit on the corners. Ooh, Rocky Johnson. If only he knew. Zoa. Terra Mox. $7. Young Rock.
Right.
Under Armour. Project Rock.
I understand. Yeah.
Young Jake. 19 years old right here. All
right. Wearing long pants then, eh?
Whew. Yeah, those are pretty solid, man.
Yeah.
RFC, duh. Yeah,
so I brought these out because I was hoping that it was like, oh, I gotta have Tyler Breeze in there, or I'm sorry,
I believe
Tyler Breeze,
Mike Dalton
is in there somewhere.
Mike Dalton was definitely in an FCW set, and I believe I was on the beach. I was a lifeguard.
Nice.
Yeah, per Alfred.
Long, bleach blonde hair.
That's it.
I remember.
But I do think, I mean, there is, I don't know if anybody's like talking about it now, but that's gotta be his rookie.
It would have to be.
Yeah.
Yeah, and especially as Seth Rollins, right?
Mm-hmm. Right, right.
Like, so could be something that could be worth something someday.
Yep. There might be one set before this. I'd have to look at the school, because I definitely have mine, because I think Claudio kept them to make fun of me.
Nice.
He literally just had a stack of them to make fun of me with. And but they were a different one. They were like kind of like a beach. I guess it was a summer one, but maybe
I know what
you're
talking about. I know
you've seen them.
Yeah.
I know you've seen them, but there was one set that might have been before this, or it might have been after it. I don't know which one was first.
Well, this is late FCW, because he only came in like towards the very end of FCW, right? Like maybe for 6 months.
I'm trying to remember.
He was there for a while.
He was there. He came in after you, right?
Maybe a couple years. So I got there in 09. I want to say he was there in 10.
Okay. He was there
for a couple years. He got called up in late 2012. Mm-hmm. So I want to say it was either, yeah, I think he was in FCW for a couple years.
Got like various unopened boxes of things.
Oh, yeah.
And while this is, there you go, absolute Jesus. Yeah. I feel like I fell for this back in the day, like gold-plated cards. I was like, oh, these are definitely going to be worth something. It's gold, baby.
I have a few gold-plated NBA cards.
Yeah, but I don't know.
Oh, raw deal.
We were
actually just, so I knew about it, but I actually just played with Woods. We played an actual round of raw deal. He's like big time into it, and he knows all the rules and stuff, so we played.
Holy cow.
Yeah, it was great. It was a fun time. And I love that Pat just gave him.
Why would I want this?
What is that stuff? Take a little peek there, WCW man.
Oh, baby.
Yeah. Surfer Sting.
What is it, just like a random photo album?
Whoever collected it must have also collected, but I think these are actually from, they are something you could have bought. Oh yeah, look, it's a poster, they're postcards.
Whoa. Oh, okay. Whew. Weird, it almost looks like someone just like collecting meet and greets or something.
Yeah, from WCW magazine.
Yeah, that's
WCW
cool.
Postcards, yeah.
Wow. That's a cool concept. I'd be into this as a kid.
Yep. Yeah. They're great quality, they're good quality pictures.
Yeah, they are. I always wanted to know what Rick's hair routine was.
What do you mean?
When he had, just look at those fluffy,
I think he just blow dried it. Blow dried it like crazy, yeah. Blow dried, it puffs right up.
Okay, I didn't know.
I used to put stuff in it to keep it down, otherwise it'd puff up.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but back then you wanted it to puff up. Arn, 18 right here.
That's the good thing about looking so old when you're young, is like, oh, you're aging really well. You just look the same from 18 to like 60.
Yeah, hasn't aged a day. Fine, Brian's got a full page of cards here. I think Rick had a bunch, Sting had a bunch, Z-Man's got three.
Right.
Three, that's it.
Terry's got some.
He's beating Z-Man. Ricky Morton still looking identical.
Legit.
Identical.
I'm telling you, Tommy Rich's hair looks exactly like that now too. It's great.
I believe it.
Beautiful.
I love that all of Ricky's cards are him getting beat up. Always getting beat up. Also, these guys are gigantic.
So jacked.
Huge.
Do you think those cards are worth anything?
Definitely.
Yeah.
100%.
Why?
First, they're in real good condition. Like, everything in here looks really solid, actually. I'd be curious. I'd be curious centering on these ones. Because they're all a tiny bit different, but actually, they're all looking pretty good. Overall, it doesn't look like they were cut bad. Corners are all still good. Surfaces are good. That's the good thing is when you're not dealing with like any holographic or foil stuff, because then the surface of the foil gets all scratched. So all you need on these ones really is like good centering. Corners and the edges have to be pretty solid, which they made the cards a lot simpler back then. So as long as like you just don't beat them up, they're good. And these are from 91. So like they have, I wonder what they, I don't know if they'd consider any of these rookies, but the WCW stuff still does very well.
Yeah, there may or may not be a couple of people that you would consider a rookie in here.
Yeah, it just depends.
Like that might be Jim Ross's rookie card.
Maybe. Yeah, true. Maybe. They just would never put like rookie on it.
Right.
It's just oh, this might be, he may never have a card before this one.
Right.
This might be the first one he's ever done. It's just a matter of like doing a little bit of research on it. But these are all in really good condition. UK WCW cards. I've never seen any of these ones. 92.
And how did you acquire these?
Through Through a collector. Okay. Through another person. Yeah, another collector. Gotcha. Somebody who actually works at WCW.
Wow. What are these?
Yeah, this is a whole different thing. I'm not like 100% on what these are.
Doesn't sound
is
that
Medusa in the middle?
It just says WCW with like a number.
Hmm.
Interesting. I've never seen these ones. Mark Miro. Or Johnny B. Bad, I guess he was. Oh, hello.
Euroflash.
I'm curious.
Okay, I wrestled him.
I'm aware.
just making sure. Them all, man. That's kind of cool. Yeah, I've never even heard of these ones. Which, if they're, what does it say, Euroflash? I wonder if they're like a European one they put out or something. Like, they gotta be, right?
Oh, yeah.
Well, it said
UK
tour, right?
Yeah, that's why I figured maybe these ones, but these ones definitely. These are cool. I've never seen these at all.
Oh, we're coming up on a good one right here.
Oh.
These are really cool.
So the Euroflash are stickers, apparently.
Okay.
Paul E. with mouth open.
Just in case you didn't know.
Right.
Paul E. dangerously, mouth almost closed. You're right. I always thought that title was cool.
Oh, yeah.
The big boy.
You know?
37.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Really?
In the 30s. I feel like he's told me a very specific number at some point. I think it's in the
30s. 37 exactly.
This one is entitled, No, Hold the Anchovies.
No, is that
Paulie?
Yeah, Paulie, yeah.
Put in a pizza order. There was clearly you could see like Sting was the golden boy.
Yeah.
He's all over this stuff. Sting was like, classic WCW. Would you like better, Surfer Sting or NWO?
Crow Sting.
Crow Sting.
Yeah, of course. Crow Sting, like, Surfer Sting was really dope, don't get me wrong, but
Crow Sting was cool, man.
Crow Sting's, like, arguably the greatest character in wrestling history to me.
Very possible.
What is the...
Shivani. Tony in front of Chicago building. Could be anything.
Well, all right.
Could be anything. Rare pre-production unnumbered samples. Very rare. Mislabeled Tracy Smothers and Scott Steiner. Ooh. Young Cactus Jack, young Steve Austin.
Again, could be. This could literally be Steve's
Liger,
rookie guard.
Your boy.
Right?
Yeah, I wonder what people say.
92. Yeah, what they actually consider to be like their rookies.
So this is 92?
92, yeah.
I'm seeing somebody posting a 91 Promi WCW Steve Austin as a rookie.
Austin rookie?
But people are also putting like WWE versions, but that's like, I mean, obviously this is before WWE.
Yep. Well, it's interesting, so I have, in 1997, they put out like a Cardinal trivia game.
Yeah.
And the trivia game, the cards are kind of considered rookies. So like there's an Austin rookie and there's a Rock rookie, and if you get the Rock 10, like it was selling for like $5,000.
Yeah.
Because it was the Rocky Maivia rookie.
Right.
And like, but it was just like, it was funny because it was just like a trivia, like a card game.
Yeah.
But like I just started buying them all up off of eBay and just getting them all graded. But like the Rocky Maivia ones and the Austin ones, I think actually Triple H, it's considered a Triple H rookie too.
Oh, okay.
But it's just so funny because they're just like trivia cards. They're just like a game. But it's so hard
to
like.
Put that out a lot faster probably than the trading card. Yeah. The card vendor at the time.
Yep. And I guess just finding what they actually consider the rookies, because none of them ever say rookie, so.
You said that was
92. 92 Steve Austin, Cactus Jack. It's gotta be close to a Cactus Jack one. Because he was only Cactus Jack, like, kind of briefly with them.
This one, somebody's posting this one. This is 91.
Yeah.
But it actually looks like it's like a different type of thing. Here's him and Flying Brian. They look like trading cards, or sorry, not trading cards, but they look like a deck of cards.
A little bit.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Playing cards.
Like playing cards, yeah. Thank you.
Interesting. Interesting. Man, these are... it's a little bit of everything. That's gonna wrap it up for us here on Breaking with Breeze. Hopefully you guys kind of liked what we saw. I know I did. I know that I'm kind of just begging to get this stuff graded. So if you guys are interested and kind of want to see this stuff get graded too, let us know in the comments. Let us know what you guys think, if you liked what you saw, if you want to see more of it, because that's what we're here for, is to give you what you want. And hopefully it's this stuff right here.